On the European Year for Development, I think it is it's a big effort from the European Commission. The 2015 is an important year, we know that, and we know the reasons for that. So we wanted to make sure that every month had a theme, an important theme. The European Development Days was also a little bit special, and it was an effort from not only from the Directorate for Development, but it was also the involvement of many other directorates, because we wanted to show that really developing cooperation is not for others, but also it is for ourselves. I mean, it's to showcase the European citizens that developing cooperation benefits all of us. Peace and security around the world is also a benefit for us. I mean, developing for others is also growth for us. So it is the mutual benefit of, and I think that is one of the main messages we wanted to achieve. And also to mark that this is an important year because of the MDGs, but mostly because of the sustainable development goals that we are going to agree upon.
Because you follow the debates this morning, what conclusions can you draw regarding the approach of this area in Romania and the cooperation with other countries, and where is it placed? Where is Romania placed in the European, among the European countries?
I must say that I am impressed. This is my first time in Romania. I don't know that much on developing cooperation from Romania, but Romania made an effort. The Ministry for Foreign Affairs made a very extensive contribution to the report that we are going to publish at the end of this year on policy coherence for development. And I was reading that report in previous months, and then I was reading that report again coming to the event. And I was really impressed of the engagement of the government, the civil society, because this is the 8th edition of this forum. So that means that there is a, it's not one-shot commitment, there is on the bottom a very truly engagement of what Romania wants to do. The discussion this morning, it was very, enlightening, because of the parliament was here, because the NGOs, the research, the combination of those that make see what it would be the role of Romania or an appropriate role. And of course, it was very interesting about what can Romania bring to developing cooperation. And of course, the transition is always mentioned. I have heard about that in Brussels several times. But this morning, there was one of the in the audience asking, what does it mean? Some people don't believe about it, some others do. But if you want to say, what can you bring to the table on to the transition? I heard very, very concrete answers. It's administrative reform, and it is the capacity building in order to become a EU member. And I like very much the message that Romania, being one of those who joined the Union lately, I mean, not, well, 2007 that is not, but it is not one of the founder members, has come with all the rights, and it has the right to have the voice, and also, the call for having that voice being heard more in Brussels and more, internationally. So I really feel very comfortable. My experience from Romania also is about following sometimes the discussion on post-2015 in Brussels at the working party of the Council. Your representative there, I am sorry, I will not be able to tell to say his name, he has a voice. So I recognize today that when you are in Brussels, there are some other countries that maybe are more silent. Romania doesn't take the floor all the time, but when they do, they have a message that is very valuable.